So today I'm gonna make an album and I'm gonna take you guys with me.
Gosh, this has been such a long time since I made a vlog. Honestly, it's been a long time since anything has happened. I've been having this crazy idea, and I'm not sure if it's gonna work because right now we can't travel anywhere, and during quarantine, a lot has happened. I've had so many moments to self-reflect. I wanted to, as a musician, take these emotions and put them into music because that's what I know best.
Breakfast. It's time for breakfast.
So, not gonna lie, breakfast is definitely my favorite meal of the day. I usually have cereal, add in some dried fruits and nuts, a scoop of ice cream, just kidding, that's Greek yogurt, with some extra honey drizzled all over. And finally, I add in soy milk. For those of you who added milk before the cereal, you're all really weird. Ah, there we go. Perfect. Breakfast of champions.
I guess all I need now is to make a studio. All right, let's do it.
So I cleared out a room and sort of set up a makeshift studio. This is the cleanest corner of the room versus, oh my gosh, we don't talk about this.
Good news, we just received the microphones and the mic stands I've already unpacked over there. So we're going to do a little unboxing to show you the equipment that we're going to be using for this project.
Whoa, look at all of that stuff. Okay, so this looks like it's going to be, yep, we got some... Oh, two ribbon mics here. Beautiful. So these are the Audio Technica. I believe they're the 4080. Let's see what's inside here. Oh, okay. Oh, okay. So we've got a stereo pair of DPA condenser mics. Wow. I got a bunch of XLR cables. Got some, oh yeah, the mounts, the microphone mounts. Grace Design preamp underneath there, lurking in there. Quite a few mics, 2, 4, and we've got those two up there with the NT5s. Make 6 microphones and a whole lot of headache to put everything together. We got this. So I decided to put up the microphone stands first because those seemed easiest, and honestly, being a musician, it's kind of like unfolding a really heavy music stand. Not exactly rocket science, but it was easy validation, which I desperately needed at this point.
Okay, so I'm ready to mount one of the microphones. This is gonna be one of the ribbon mics. Do you believe in me? 'Cause I believe in you. How do I know if it's the right way around? Oh gosh, this is
you're my skinny violin fingers.
I got it. Ha, boom, boom, doo, doo, da, 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 ba, ba. Aha! I'm a mic mounting genius. If I was a mountain, I would be called Mount Mike. Okay, so here we have the preamp, and the microphones are supposed to connect to the back of the preamp. You can see I've already got one connected there. Preamp is then connected to audio interface. Through, I think, what's called an ADI cable. Actually, I have no clue what I am doing, so yeah, let's just see what happens. What could go wrong? Oh. So I think that at this point, we've set up pretty much everything we could on our own. Now it's time to figure out where the best position for the mics ought to be. And for that, I'm definitely going to call my producer, who's going to help me test out and figure out where the best position can be. I think that adding a professional to the equation at this point can really make a huge difference. So I'm going to go ahead and see what he has to say.
Hi, how's it going?
Hey, Brian. Yeah, good. I'm fine. How are you?
I have no idea what I'm doing.
There we go. Okay, let's get going.
Was one the left? So is it my right?
So yeah, we encountered a tiny little issue before we started, but I've since fixed it. I mean, my computer fan was a little bit too loud, so I put it out there, and yeah, modern solutions require modern problems.
All right, so how this is gonna work is Jonathan, my producer, who's currently based in London, is gonna be remotely controlling the software and my computer, and yeah, hopefully nothing else in my computer, haha. And he's gonna be able to help me you know, record the entire recording process and, you know, take notes. It's always important to have a real professional on the other line. And yeah, hopefully I'll be able to focus more on the music. So, hi, Jonathan.
Hey, folks. Yeah, so I'll be operating and then listening in basically CD quality at my end through my computer at my studio.
Awesome. Kind of a little bit nervous.
Okay,
Yeah, it's all right. All right, so it's after lunch, and I'm going to prank Jonathan by playing the $69 violin and seeing if he can tell the difference. All right, Jonathan, I'm ready to record. You good?
Yeah, we're in. Just give me a second. There's something not right. It's like, could be the connection, or it could be
connection. Right. Let me just retune. Maybe I just need to retune.
Okay.
Oh yeah, it was a little. My violin was out of tune. All right.
Start the piece again.
All right. Let's do it. Let's just do a test. We'll do a quick test. How was that?
Are you sure you weren't playing with it at lunchtime?
I didn't touch anything. I mean, I didn't change anything on the computer.
Just play something on the G string.
Yeah, sure.
It's feeling like you've.
All right. I was playing. All right. So your ears are pretty good, Jonathan. I was playing on the $69 violin. So all right, Jonathan Allen, everyone. You passed the test. It was all a test. I was just testing you.
I finally hear the difference between us.
All right. We'll go back to work now. Anything we need to do?
Nothing, we're good!
It's the end, yes! But now I get to hear what's on your computer.
Exactly, and then I can make changes to the reverb, and you can hear the changes.
Wow, technology!
No, I finally finished the album! Yes, the recording part is done. And I've listened to the tracks. It was actually a great time. Jonathan was super helpful, and we listened to all the parts together, made some, you know, selections of which tracks we liked best. And, you know, at the end of the day, I feel like even though the whole experience was really difficult, I mean, I struggled immensely with everything, I learned a lot. And would I do it again? Absolutely. It has been such a rewarding experience that, yeah, I have a lot to thank. So thank you so much to Decca and for those people around me, which helped me a lot, you know, who you are, and giving me advice, pushing me through this quite a difficult project. And I also want to tell you that I finally learned how to do proper cable management. Look at this. Look how clean this is. Look at the floor. It's so clean. Like, where's all the cables? They're up here because I finally became an adult. So, thanks for the experiences, and bye.